Welcome to last class. We discussed regarding D block elements. Today we are going to discuss F block elements. Last class D block elements totally completed. Now we are going to discuss F block elements. But listen, before going to this F block elements question, they will ask mainly from F block elements and from D block elements also they will ask. But listen, this lesson D and F block elements and coordination compounds, combination lesson this is. D and F block elements, coordination compounds, together they are asking in NEET 3 to 4 questions they are asking. So here it is. This is D and F block elements, that coordination. From coordination, they will ask two questions. From this, if they given two questions, one question from D block, one question they will ask from F block. But maximum times they are asking 4 to 5 questions from this D and F block elements and coordination compounds. 5 means 5 fours are 20 marks we can cover from this D and F and coordination compounds. So that's why this F block elements also please concentrate more and more. Here it is D block elements and now this is F block elements. Please try to understand very carefully. This is to understand this F block elements. Once again I am repeating the total configurations of D block elements and then I will explain for F block elements. First I am repeating electronic configuration and elements of D block elements, then from that electronic configuration to I will take the electronic configuration for F block elements. So now here it is. First, once again we will discuss electronic configuration for 3D series. 3D series electronic configuration I am writing. This is 3D series electronic configurations. Already we discussed, but here again discussion is needed to understand electronic configuration for F block elements. So now elements are 3D series: scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium and manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper and zinc. These are the 3D series elements: scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc. In this, first of all, we have to understand, we have to identify the exceptions. Two exceptions there, one is chromium, another one is copper. So here it is, 3D series means electrons are entering into 3D subshell. So I am giving here it is 4s electrons and 3d electrons. Where exception is coming, there s subshell contains only one electron, one extra electron we has to add into d subshell. So now here it is, here no exception means 4s2 3d1, this is 4s2 3d2, this is 4s2 3d3. Here actually 4s2 3d4 I am expecting, but this is 4s1 3d5 configuration. This is 4s2 3d6. This is 4s2 3d7. 4s2 3d8. This is 4s2. Here it is 4s2 3d1, 4s2 3d2, 4s2 3d3, this is 4s1 3d5, this is 4s2 3d5. Why? Because the electron entering into this. This is 4s2 3d6, 4s2 3d7, this is 4s2 3d8, this is 4s1 3d10, this is 4s2 3d10. Very simple, this is 21 D1, 22 D2, 23 D3, 25 D5, 26 D6, 27 D7, 28 D8, 30 D10. So like this, this is the electronic configuration for which series? This is 3D series. 3D series, this is the electronic configuration. In this only two exceptions, one is chromium, another one is copper. Now I am going to explain electronic configuration for 4D series. 4D series. Here 4D series first element is, this is yttrium. Yttrium, next zirconium, niobium. Niobium, here it is molybdenum, and technetium, ruthenium, rhodium, palladium, this is silver, and cadmium. So these are the elements: yttrium, zirconium, niobium, molybdenum, technetium, ruthenium, rhodium, palladium, silver, cadmium. So these are the which group elements? Which series element? 4D series. So now 4D series means electron centers into 4D shell. So 4D shell means this is 5S and 4D. 5S and 4D. Here these are the two exceptions. Here except these two, remaining all are exceptions. So here you make one box for this. These are no exception. Remaining all are exceptions. Here no exception means it contains two electrons. Exception means it contains only one electron. This is a double exception. So that's why two electrons, these two electrons we have to lift there. So this is one, this is so now once again electronic configuration. Here except these two, remaining all are exceptions. Palladium is double exception. Single exception means we have to lift one electron from general valency shell. Electronic configuration already we know. N minus 1D, 1 to 10, NS, NS 0, 1, 2. This is the general valency shell electronic configuration. But to understand the two right configuration very easily, we have to take this is NS2 only. Single exception means we have to lift one electron from NS2 N minus 1D. Double exception means two electrons we have to lift from NS2 N minus 1D. That's all. This is the simple technique to write the electronic configuration. And my dear students, please try to understand. Here, sir, why like this electronic configuration is coming? Listen carefully. It is everything we are explaining for stability. And listen carefully. By writing these configurations, we are not explaining the stability. By checking stability of atom, we are explaining this configuration. Configuration to stability, no. Stability to configuration only. Stability is the matter of laboratory. Configuration is the matter of theory, classroom. So that's why listen, here it is, this chromium is more stable than vanadium and vanadium. So that's why we have to write the configuration like this. So listen once again, here it is, configurations, we are not explaining stability. Already molecule is stabilized, that is checked inside the laboratory. So now classroom we are developing this theory. So these are the configurations. So here it is, how to write this configuration very conveniently means, here listen carefully, where exceptions are coming, those you concentrate. So here it is, single exception means from NS2 single electron you lift to N minus 1D. Double exception means double. No exception means it contains two electrons. Listen here, no exception, two electron, no exception, two electron, no exception, two electron. Here one single exception means single electron we have to lift from this 4s to 3d. No exception, two electron, no exception, two electron, no exception, two electron, no exception, two electron. Here exception, One electron I am lifting from this 4s2 3d, so like that. And here it is in this also, excluding these two remaining all exceptions, here double exception will come. So here no exception means 2 2, single electron means one electron I am lifting from ns2 n-1d, 1 1 1 1 1, double exception means two electrons I am lifting, 0 here exception. Listen, this zinc, cadmium, mercury, the last elements, you know already, those are not transition elements, those are d block elements. Here no exceptions, last no exceptions. So totally here it is, this is 5s2 4d1, this is 5s2 4d2. So now here it is 5s2 4d3 I am expecting, but this is 4d4. Why? Because one electron I am lifting, one new electron coming into d, one electron is shifting from ns2 n-1d. Once again listen, here it is, I am expecting 5s2 4d3, but this become 5s1 4d4. One electron due to exception is coming from ns2 n-1d, means 5s2 to 4d, and one new electron coming. So this is 5s1 4d4, 5s1 4d5, 4d6 4d7, 4d8, this is two exceptions, 4d10. So here it is also, this is also 10, this is also 10. So this is the configuration totally. Here see, listen once again, configuration 5s2 4d1, 5s2 4d2, 5s1 4d4. So here 3 missed here, 4 5 6 7 8, here 9 missed. Why? Because double exception. Double exception here it is, for suppose general configuration I am writing, here it is 4s2, so 5s2, this is 5s2 4d1, 5s2 4d2, 5s2 4d3, 4 5 6 7 8, we has to get. Double exception means 10 is coming there. So single exception 9 we are expecting, 10 is coming. So this is the configuration of which series? 4d series. Configuration for this is 4d series. This is 4D series, and now I am explaining 5D series. 5D series. 5D series means the electron centers into 5D subshell. So here it is, next here it is, element is lanthanum. Lanthanum, next element is hafnium. First here it is lanthanum, next hafnium. So here it is, lanthanum, here it is. Lanthanum, next hafnium. In 5D series, lanthanum next element is hafnium. But here it is, lanthanum next element actually not a hafnium, lanthanum next element is cerium. So here it is, this is vanadium, niobium, here it is hafnium, next is, this is tantalium. Next one is tungsten. Next one is rhenium, osmium, iridium, and platinum. This is iron, gold, and this is the mercury. So these are the 5D series elements. Lanthanum, hafnium, this is tantalium, tungsten, rhenium, osmium, iridium, platinum, iron, mercury. So now what I am going to say, why I am explaining this d block elements, it is the time to understand. Here it is scandium, this is scandium, down element is yttrium, yttrium down element is lanthanum, next element is actinium. So actinium means scandium between yttrium, one gap is there, yttrium between lanthanum, one gap is there, lanthanum between actinium, one gap is there. So means total in D block 3 gaps there. Our magic numbers 2, 8, 8, 18, 18, 32. So 3 gaps means 3 magic numbers we have to select. So these are the 3 magic numbers. These are the 3 magic numbers. Here scandium atomic number I know, that is 21. So scandium plus 18. 21 plus 18. 21 plus 18 is 39. 39 plus 18 is 57. So means this is 21 and yttrium is 39 and here it is lanthanum is 57. But hafnium is not, 58, hafnium is 72. It is lanthanum 57. After 58 is not hafnium, hafnium is 72. 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70 and 71. Total 14. These are not belongs to this 5D series. So 57, next 72 onwards, here it is D block element 72, 73, 74, like that it will come. So now these configurations also I am giving to you. In this you know already two exceptions will come, that is one is platinum, another one is arum. These are the two exceptions. 5D series means electrons are entering into 5D shell. So here it is 6s and 5D. So here it is no exception means 2, here it is 2, 2. Where exceptions not there, there 2, 2 electrons will come. Where exception will present there 1, 1 electron in S subshell. Where double exception there 0 will come. Here no exception, that is 2. Last elements no exception. So now here it is, this is 6s2, 5d1, 5d2, 5d3, 5d4, 5d5, 5d6, 5d7. This is 5d9, this is 5d10, 5d10. So these are the configurations of 5D series. This is 5D series. Now I am explaining roughly about 6D series. 6D series. In 6D series, the element is here, it is actinium. Actinium next element is rutherfordium. Rutherfordium to last element is this copernicium. So here it is, listen, here also this is our magic numbers are 18, 18 and 32. Here 21 plus 18, here to here 18. So here to here 32 if we use, this is actinium 89. Actinium 89. Actinium next element is also not rutherfordium. Middle 14 elements you left there. 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98. 99, 100, 101, 102, 103. So this is rutherfordium is 104. So here it is 105, 106, this is 107, 108, this is 109, 110, 111, this is 112. Cn is 112, that is the last element in periodic table copernicium. So here also configuration, just this actinium configuration I am giving to you. Actinium configuration is, here it is 6d means this is 7s comma 6d. This is 7s2 6d1, this is 7s2 6d1. Here it is 7s2 6d2, like this will come. So no need the configuration. In middle also 14 elements are not belongs to this D block, means 6D series, those belongs to F block. Now listen, lanthanum between hafnium, these 14 elements are belongs to 4F series lanthanides. Why? Because elements are coming after the lanthanum. So now actinium between ruther-4-dm also, between 14 elements, those are not belongs to D block. Those are belongs to 5F series, that we call actinides. Why? Because elements coming after the actinium. So totally, once again, what I am going to say, I am introducing to you F block elements. Lanthanum between hafnium, the 14 elements are belongs to 4F series. Why they are belongs to 4F series? Just wait. So these are 4F series lanthanides. Elements which are coming after the lanthanum are lanthanides. Elements which are coming after the actinium, the 14 elements we called in 5F series, that is actinide series. Elements which are coming after the actinium, actinide series. So this is, here it is, listen carefully. Now I am introducing to you F block elements. F block elements, first I am explaining to you lanthanides. Lanthanides, simply we show this with LN, simple notation LN. So here it is, lanthanum, next element here it is, cerium. So next here it is, cerium. Next element is praseodymium. Cerium, praseodymium. And listen carefully, why I given this 3D, 4D, 5D series elements electronic configuration. Here it is, the cerium atomic number. Lanthanum 57 means cerium atomic number is 58. And here it is, listen, this is configuration, here it is 6s2 5d1. It is actually xenon 6s2 5d1. Why xenon 6s2 5d1? Means here it is helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. Helium atomic number 2, 2 plus 8 10, 10 plus 8 18, this is 36, 36 plus 18 54, xenon 54, 56, 57, 57. So means these are close to xenon configuration. So here it is cerium, this is xenon, 57 means 58 I am writing. So 57 to 58 configuration is xenon, 6s2, 5d2 already hafnium. That's why listen what happened here it is, after lanthanum, this cerium electronic configuration is not 6s2 5d2, its configuration is 4f1. After this 5d1, next electron not enters into 5d2, that is 5d1, next the electron enters into 4f1. That's why this cerium is not included here. Once again, I am explaining clearly, listen carefully. Lanthanum 57 means its configuration is xenon 6s2 5d1. Next, cerium 58, I am expecting configuration 6s2 5d2, but instead of 6s2 5d2, it become, this is 5d1 6s2, means as it is 5d1 6s2. The next electron enters into 4f shell. It is not into 5d shell. It is not 5d2. It is 4f1. That's why these 14 elements are included in lanthanides. Why these called 4f series? Means electrons enters into 4f sub shell. That's why we called these are 4f series or lanthanide series. So here it is, xenon 4f1 5d1 6s2. And here it is, next one, here it is prosodium, next element is. Its atomic number 59, here it is, this is xenon. Listen, here it is, this is cerium, is the element, it is the immediate element after D block. That's why this one D electron is continuing here. But after that there was no D electrons. So this D electron will shift into this. When D electron will shift into this, this is 4F2 and one new extra electron is coming. That's why this is 4F3 6S2. Once again I am explaining, listen, here it is. This is the cerium is the immediate element after the D block. So that's why what happened, one electron will continue in this cerium, 5D1 will continue, this 5D1 will continue into cerium and next electron enters into 4F. But from prosodium, next element, this D0, 5D0, this electron also enters into 4F, one new extra electron is coming. So 4F3, 6S2. So here it is, cerium, prosodium, so this is the 5D series. Cerium, prosodium, neodymium, niobium, NB. Next one here it is promethium, next one samarium, cerium, prosodium, niobium, promethium, samarium, this is europium and gadolinium. Terbium, dysprosium, holmium, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, holmium, and it is erbium, next is thulium, next is ytterbium, next one is lutetium. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 elements. Cerium, prosodium, niobium, here it is promethium, samarium, europium, gadolinium, terbium, dysprosium, holmium, erbium, thulium, here it is ytterbium and lutetium. Okay, so now here the configuration, this is 60, this is xenon, 4F4 6S2, 4F4 6S2, this is 61, this is xenon 4F5 6S2, and this is 62, here it is xenon 4F6 6S2, and here it is europium 63, and this is xenon 4F7 6S2, gadolinium 64, this is xenon. Listen carefully, F subshell give opportunity for 14, 7 means half will completed. So this is stable configuration. Next, immediately it won't lose stability, so that's why again 5D1 will come. Where stability for F subshell is coming, there the stability will continue in one more element. So this is also, here it is 4F7 and 5D1 6S2, it configuration very simple. Here stability coming, next immediately it won't lose stability, one more element also it will continue the stability. So now here it is, this is 65. 65 means one electron into this 4f8. Now extra electron is coming, 4f9. So xenon 4f9 6s2. Here it is dysprosium 66. This is xenon 4f10 6s2. This is 67 holmium. This is xenon 4f11 6s2. And erbium 68. This is xenon 4f12 and 6s2. And this is 69. Here it is xenon 4f13 6s2. Here it is ytterbium 70. This is xenon 4f14 6s2. So now here it is last lutetium 71. It is xenon 4f14. 14 stable. So next again 5d1 will come. 5d1 6s2. So these are the electronic configurations. So now in that electronic configurations you see 58 to 71 58 cerium, praseodymium, this is neodymium, Nd, cerium, praseodymium, neodymium, promethium, samarium, europium, gadolinium, terbium, dysprosium, holmium, erbium, thulium and ytterbium, lutetium. So these are the 58 to 71. Now are you understood? I think you are understood why I given 3D, 4D, 5D configurations. 2-3 times you practice, you get the idea of electronic configurations. And listen once again in this, this promethium is a radioactive element. Radioactive element, remaining all are non-radioactive elements. Lanthanide series, only promethium is radioactive element, remaining all are non-radioactive elements. We are calling D block elements are transition elements. F block elements are inner transition elements. Those are transition, these are inner transition elements. And one more here it is, this is an electronic configuration. Once again I am explaining. This is cerium is the immediate element after the lanthanum. Lanthanum is not radioactive, lanthanum is not lanthanide element. Cerium is the lanthanide element. The elements which are coming after lanthanum is the lanthanides. So CD, cerium 58. Actually, I am expecting 6s2, 5d2. But the next electron enters into 4f1. And here it is, this is 5d1. It is cerium immediate element after the lanthanum. That's why that electron is continuing here. But from next onwards, it won't continue. It will shift into, this means 4F2. Listen carefully, we have to understand one more also. Electron is shifting from here to here means, here the energy gap. Gap is also be less. Then only electrons will shift. For suppose, listen, why D block elements show variable oxidation states? Why D block elements show variable oxidation state means there is a less energy gap between S orbital and D orbital. Here also listen, why here electron is lifting into here to here means energy gap between these two are 4F and 5D is very less. That's why what happened here it is, electrons are shifting here to here. And here in this energy gap between 6S and 5D also be less here. So simply you remember, energy gaps between these shells is very less. That's why what happened, electrons will shift here, here, like that, differently will shift here it is. So filling of electrons are differently going in lanthanides because of the energy gaps between these are very less. So now here it is, praseodymium 4F3, 6S2, 4F4, 4F5, 4F6, 4F7. Where stability is coming, that configuration will continue in one more element. to maintain stability in the next element, again electron shift into 5d, 9 10 11 12 13 14. So to continue one more time the stability, 5d1. So now general valency shell electronic configuration. Listen, this is the valency shell, this is the penultimate shell, this is the anti-penultimate shell. Last shell is valency shell, next is penultimate shell, next is anti-penultimate shell. This is n means this is n minus 1, this is n minus 2. So now configuration is, this I am explaining for lanthanides. Lanthanides general valency shell electronic configuration is n minus 2f, 1 to 14, there was no 0, n minus 2f, 1 to 14, and n minus 1d, n minus 1d, 0 is there, and 1 is there, 2 is not there. So n minus 1d, 0 comma 1, and ns2, all S subshells contains 1, 1. Or else simply I can say this is 4F 1 to 14 5D 0 comma 1 and 6S2. So these are the general electronic configuration for which lanthanides, N minus 2F 1 to 14, N minus 1D 0 comma 1 NS2, or else 4F 1 to 14 5D 0 comma 1 6S2. So this is your electronic configuration, general electronic configuration. Now I am explaining, here it is oxidation states. Oxidation states, these elements show totally three type of oxy acids, plus 2 and plus 3 and plus 4. Plus 2, plus 3, plus 4. And listen carefully, any element lose electrons or gain electrons to get stability. Here which elements shows plus 2, which element shows plus 3, which element shows plus 4, that we have to understand. For suppose, listen here, it is in this. Generally, these use electrons from S and D. They use electrons from S and D to show oxidation states. Why they show S and D, why not 4F? That is the condition. What is the condition there? Means what is the condition to utilize electrons from S and D, why not from 4F in their oxidation states? The reason is, already you know, this F subshells improper shielding present. Improper shielding means these F subshells are not absorbs that much nucleus power. That's why the nucleus power on valency shells are more. So the nucleus power on valency shells are more means the atomic radius decreases. Here it is, listen, cerium 2, this lutetium. Here atomic radius, cerium 2 lutetium decreases. This cerium to lutetium atomic radius decreases. Atomic radius decreases means ionization potential increases. Rough explanation I am giving, next I will give one by one detail explanation. Atomic radius from cerium to lutetium decreases. This is only we called lanthanide contraction. What is lanthanide contraction? Means the elements which are coming after the lanthanum, electrons enters into F subshells cannot screen that much nucleus charge. So means due to improper shielding of this 4F subshell, the nucleus charge, that positive charge of nucleus on further shells, means here it is 5D, 6S or 6S. So the further shells which are coming after the 4F increases. Nucleus force on valency shell increases, atomic radius decreases. So here it is, atomic radius cerium to lutetium decreases. The reason is lanthanide contraction. Here generally we get one doubt. Sir, these all are present in horizontal line. So means period, horizontal lines are period. So in period from left to right, atomic radius decreases, same way it is decreasing. Please beta, this is not period, this is the group. Here these are belongs to, these total, these lanthanides are belongs to, these are belongs to third group. Third group, sixth period. Already you know, this is a cerium before element is there, na? Cerium before element. Cerium before element is lanthanum. So lanthanum present in which period means sixth period. And next cerium is there, na? That is also present in sixth period, but belongs to third group. Third group, sixth period, these are. In group from top to bottom, I am expecting what happened? This third group sixth period, in group top to bottom atomic radius, I am expecting increase in atomic radius. Or else listen carefully, here it is 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63 numbers 1111 unit increasing. So we consider these all are present in period, that's why they given in horizontal line. Once again listen carefully, atomic number 1111 unit increasing means those are belongs to period. So these all are belongs to period. Which period means? That is sixth period. Which group means? Third group. So here it is, in period from left to right, atomic radius decreases. Here also atomic radius decreases. Why atomic radius decreases means this F subshells improper shielding increases nuclear charge on further shells, means valency shells, valency shell or penultimate shell. So atomic radius decreases. Wherever atomic radius decreases, ionization potential increases. So means here it is, when due to shielding effect these shells are coming close to the nucleus, means the energy gap between these two also decreases. Why? Because the 6s 5d also coming very close. When shells are coming close, means energy gap between that also less. That's why listen carefully, here it is, the 6s and 5d means electrons from S subshell, electrons from D subshell, generally this lanthanides use in its oxidation states. Along with that, sometimes they use 4f also, but generally maximum they use this. Question they will ask, why D block elements show variable oxidation states, means there is less energy gap between S and D subshell. Here also less energy gap between S and D subshell. Less energy gap why present means D and F subshells are improper shielding effect. Due to that improper shielding effects, therein, this is valency, penultimate shell. Therein penultimate shell, here also in penultimate shell. Valency and penultimate shells both are come closer to the nucleus. That's why these two also come close. So energy gap is less. Due to less energy gap, these all are showing variable oxidation state. Once again I am explaining why D block elements, why F block elements show variable oxidation states, means here in this D subshell and F subshell both are improper shielding effect, means they won't screen that much nuclear charge. So the nuclear charge on further shells, what happen? Increases. When nuclear charge on further shells increases, atomic radius decreases. When atomic radius decreasing, means shells are come close. That's why these shells also come close. Energy gap between these two shells is less. When energy gap between these two less means, if we give an energy, electrons will come out from this as well as from this. So that's why here it is, these show variable oxidation states. If we give a little extra energy, this along with these two, this also will come. So listen, here it is, very low energy if we given, that is this oxidation state. Some little high energy along with this, this also will come. So means When we pass energy to these elements, they can lose electrons from this as well as this. That's why irrespective of noble gas configuration, they lose electrons. When energy gap between shells are less, if we give an energy, they lose electrons from their valency shells as well as penultimate shells. So here it is, for which oxidation, for which elements plus 2 oxidation state is more stable. For suppose listen, I'm telling listen carefully, here it is, lutetium plus 3 stable, is you accept or not? Here it is plus 3 stable. Why here plus 3 stable means, if it will lose these 3 electrons, 4F14 fulfilled configuration, that's why lutetium stable in plus 3. And ytterbium, I am telling it is stable in plus 2 oxidation state. I think you are understood. This is plus 3 stable. Why? Because 4F14 stable. Here it is, by loss of 2 electrons, it is 4F14 plus 2 stable. So I can say ytterbium is stable in plus 2 oxidation state. Lutetium stable in plus 3 oxidation state. But listen, all elements they show along with plus, means this plus 3 common for all. Cerium 2, lutetium, every element will show plus 3 oxidation state. But here plus 3, 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 all are plus 3 possible. But compared to plus 3 stable or other oxidation states are stable. For suppose, here it is, by loss of these 2 electrons only, it show plus 2. By loss of these 2 and this one, it show plus 3. Which is stable means I can say this is. And here it is, along with plus 2, plus 3 possible. Means 2 electrons from 6s, 1 electron from 4f. Then this plus 3 possible. But I can vote for plus 2 is more stable. Why plus 2 is more stable means, there by loss of 2 electrons, it reaches 4f14 fulfilled configuration. And here it is, this is, here it is plus 3 stable. 2 electrons from this, 1 electron from this. Why? Because here no stabilized configuration. 4F12 also not fulfilled, not half filled. So that's why plus 3. Sir, plus 4, plus 5 means first ionization potential greater than second, greater than third. So after that, removal of electron is highly difficult. So I am stopping up to plus 3. So this is also, here it is plus 3 stable. Here also plus 3 stable. Here also plus 3 stable. Here it is, listen in this. Terbium. Terbium case, what I am doing here it is, this is plus 2, plus 3, plus 4 also possible here. Why? Because here it is, from this 2, if I remove 4 electrons, means it become half filled. So here it is, this will show plus 2 and plus 3 and plus 4. But stable one I vote for, this is. Why? For terbium plus 4 is more stable means, 2 electrons from this, 2 electrons from this, this become 4F7. Here gadolinium is stable in which oxidation state? Plus 3. And this is stable in which oxidation state? Plus 2. Along with plus 2 possible also plus 3. Here stable is what? Plus 3. Here stable is what? From 2 here it is 1 plus 3. Here it is also plus 3. Here it is plus 3. So plus 3 oxidation is possible for all elements. But stable one here it is. Here it is wherever other oxidations. Generally you see these elements show plus 2, plus 3, plus 4. Plus 2, plus 3, plus 4. These are the oxidation states possible for lanthanides. What our discussion is, plus 3 stable or plus 2 or plus 4, that we have to cross check. Listen, cerium will show, here it is, cerium will show plus 3 oxidation state. Plus 3 oxidation state. And this cerium, regarding this cerium, plus 3 comma plus 4 both possible. Why plus 3 comma plus 4 possible means, plus 3 is the common oxidation state for lanthanides. Plus 4 means it lose all 4 electrons, it reach xenon noble gas configuration. So for cerium, I can give vote for plus 4 oxidation state. Cerium plus 4 oxidation state. This is praseodymium 2 and 1. Here it is 3 oxidation state plus 3. Here it is neodymium also plus 3. Praseodymium also plus 3. And here it is samarium also plus 3. But europium you cross check, here it is plus 2 plus 3, both possible. But stable one is plus 2. Stable one is plus 2. Why stable one plus 2 means? By loss of 2 electrons it reaches 4F7 half field configuration. Gadolinium, here it is 2 plus 1 3. Here it is plus 3. It is also half field stable. Here these and all plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 stable. And when I take here it is this ytterbium plus 2 plus 3, which is stable means plus 2. And lutetium, here it is, which is stable means plus 3. So these are the oxidation states. So here it is oxidation state possible, plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, 3 oxidation states possible. So listen, here it is, based on these oxidation states we can give paramagnetism and diamagnetic nature. Unpaired electrons present, that is paramagnetism. Paired electrons present, that is diamagnetism. For suppose I am asking, here it is, this is cerium plus 3, cerium plus 4. What is your opinion? Cerium plus 3 means I am removing 2 plus 1 3 electrons and 1 unpaired there. So that's why this is paramagnetism. This is paramagnetism. Cerium plus 4 means 2 plus 1 3 plus 1 4. Or 4 electrons I am removing. That's why this is which magnetism? Diamagnetism. One is paramagnetism, another one is diamagnetism. What about praseodymium plus 3? This is which magnetism? This is which magnetism? Paramagnetism. It is also which magnetism? Para. It is also which magnetism? Para. Here para, para, here it is. Once again here it is. What about ytterbium plus 2? YB plus 2. YB plus 2. YB plus 2, ytterbium plus 2, ytterbium plus 3. Ytterbium plus 2. Plus 2 is diamagnetism and plus 3 is paramagnetism. What about lutetium plus 3? Diamagnetism. Like that we can give the magnetic nature. 2018, they given question, in the following which is paramagnetism, they given cerium plus 4, like that ytterbium plus 2, so like that elements they given. So here it is, which is paramagnetism, which is diamagnetism. That's why I am telling, listen, this paramagnetism, diamagnetism I can explain by knowing the electronic configurations only. Otherwise we can't tell this is. So here it is, simply listen, wherever F unpaired electrons present, that is paramagnetism. Wherever in F all are paired present, that is diamagnetism. In 2018, the correct answer cerium plus 4 option. Cerium plus 4 is diamagnetism, but cerium plus 3 is paramagnetism. So it is explanation about diamagnetism and paramagnetism. Once again, listen carefully. Lanthanides, here it is cerium to lutetium. These are the total electronic configurations, and atomic radius from cerium to lutetium decreases. That we call a lanthanide contraction. These all elements belongs to third group, sixth period. So here it is, listen, these will show plus 2, plus 3, plus 4 oxidation state. Here it is, where plus 2, where plus 3, where plus 4 oxidation state is stable means we have to check out the electronic configuration. By removal of electron, any stabilized configurations are coming, such oxidation states are stable. Example, once again I am giving, cerium plus 3 plus 4 possible, but stable is plus 4. Cerium plus 3, one unpaired electrons in F, that's why para. Cerium plus 4, there was no unpaired electron, that's why dia. And here it is ytterbium, by loss of 2 electrons plus 2, 2 and 1 electron plus 3, but stable is this one. After removal of 2 electrons from 6s, ytterbium plus 2 is full field configuration, there was no unpaired electrons in F subshell, that's why that is dia. So here it is lutetium also plus 3 stable, this is also dia. So like that, diamagnetism, paramagnetism, oxidation states, and what about atomic radius? Now I am taking this ionization potential. Ionization potential and listen, this lanthanides, if we understood actinides very easy. And here in this ionization potential, very simple, this ionization potential, already we know cerium to lutetium atomic radius decreases. Ionization potential is inversely proportional to atomic radius. That meaning cerium to lutetium ionization atomic radius decreasing means ionization potential increases. And where stabilizer configurations are coming, their ionization potential will be more. Generally, cerium to lutetium increases. Where stabilizer configuration is coming, their ionization potential again increases more and more. So this is the information about ionization potential. And one more here it is, listen what I am explaining. This is S block, here it is D block, and here it is F block elements like this. D block, here it is F block, S block, D block, down F block, totally it is P block. So now what I am here going to, here it is, this left to right atomic radius decreases, so ionization potential increases. So ionization potential increasing means, actually this F block elements also including in D only I am explaining. Why? Because these we written separately in the bottom of the periodic table, but these also belongs to third group and sixth period only. So now atomic radius decreasing, ionization potential increasing. First, if I take D block elements, here atomic radius more. Here atomic radius less. Here ionization potential more, here ionization potential is less. That meaning, listen carefully, this D block elements contains more ionization potential than S block elements, less ionization potential than P block elements. Same like the way this F block elements also more ionization potential than S block elements, less ionization potential than P block elements. And here it is one more, this is basic nature. Basic nature here it is, this general common oxidation state is plus 3. That's why by taking Ln, lanthanides plus 3, all lanthanides common oxidation state plus 3, these will show LnOH taken thrice hydroxide. This is means CeOH taken thrice, YbOH taken thrice, like that hydroxides will form. It is not lanthanide, lanthanide elements I am showing with Ln. So lanthanum means La, that is Ln I written there. Ln means lanthanides. So now here it is, listen, actually what happened, basic strength and ionization potential both are inversely proportional. Sir, how you know this basic strength and ionization potential are inversely proportional? This is a lithium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, rubidium hydroxide, cesium hydroxide. Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Lithium to cesium ionization potential decreases, but basic character increases. where ionization potential less, their basic strength is more. So this is the point here. So now listen carefully here. In this, I am taking calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide. And I am taking cerium hydroxide. And I am taking aluminium hydroxide. AlOH taken thrice. So here to here, what happened? Atomic radius decreases. So ionization potential increases. So basic strength decreases. Basic strength decreases means it is a weaker base and it is the stronger base. That meaning lanthanides, COOH taken thrice. This lanthanides basic strength is, lanthanides basic strength is lesser than S block elements but more than P block elements. These basic strength, lanthanides basic strength is more than less than alkali and alkali earth metals but more than P block elements. Why? Because atomic radius, ionization potential, basic strength relation this is. And one more in this, this is cerium to lutetium. Cerium to lutetium, what happened? Atomic radius decreases, so ionization potential increases, so basic strength decreases. That meaning CeOH taken thrice, LuOH taken thrice. Which one is stronger acid means? CeOH taken thrice is stronger acid. Cerium to lutetium also basic strength what happened? Decreases. So this is the information about the basic strength, ionization potential, atomic radius. And generally these lanthanides properties we compare with second A group elements. So this is the, and listen here, it is one more property also. These are showing positive oxidation state, means these also act as reducing agents. They are like S block elements, these are also good reducing agents. These properties we can compare with second A group elements, especially with calcium. Once again I am explaining, listen carefully. Oxidation states we discussed, +2, +3, +4. Where +2 stable, where +3 stable, where +4 stable, we can understand easily. Any half-filled, full-filled configuration coming or not, like that we have to cross-check. Otherwise, +3 oxidation state stable. Example I given to you, cerium. For cerium, +3, +4 possible, but +4 is more stable. Ytterbium, +2, +3 possible, but stable is +2. So like that, we can explain which oxidation state is stable. After oxidation state, you just cross check F subshell contains any single electrons, that is para, otherwise dia. And atomic radius, we know already, cerium to lutetium decreases. Atomic radius decreasing means ionization potential increasing. So means this ionization potential is more than S, less than P. So now from that I am explaining basic strength. This general common oxidation state is +3. Common oxidation state is +3. Every element of lanthanide series contains +3. So that's why LnOH taken thrice I am taking. In this LnOH taken thrice, here I am taking, this is S block hydroxide, it is P block hydroxide. Basic strength is inversely proportional to ionization potential. So left to right ionization potential increases means basic strength decreases. Means this lanthanide's basic strength is lesser than S block elements but more than P block elements. So cerium to lutetium also atomic radius decreases, ionization potential increases, basic strength decreases. So this is, these all are, these lanthanides all are showing positive oxidation state. That's why these are act as reducing agents like S block elements. These act as reducing agent, good reducing agent, but compared to S block, these are not good reducing agents. So this is information about reducing agents. And listen one more in this. Chemical reactions. Chemical reactions. And listen carefully here, it is, we consider plus 3 oxidation state. Okay, from by plus 3 only we can explain every chemical reaction. But listen, we have to remember this LN means lanthanides. With carbon it forms LnC2. That we have to remember. With carbon it forms LnC2, but remaining all we give compounds with the help of plus 3 oxidation state. This is LN. LN I am taking which oxidation state? Plus 3. I am doing combustion reaction. Here it is LN plus 3 and O minus 2. Means the product is LN2O3. So your product will come LN2O3. So lanthanides on combustion with O2 forms LN2O3 type oxides. With sulfur, I am reacting with sulfur. Then also it shows LN2S3. And with carbon, we know that is LnC2. And for suppose with nitrogen, nitrogen means it present in N-3. So forms LnN. So here it is with nitrogen, LnN. And here it is with water. With water, already we know that forms LnOH taken thrice and releases hydrogen. Already I explained one point to you. The point is which reduction potential, standard reduction potential is lesser than hydrogen. Those liberates hydrogen from, for suppose this is Zn plus H2O. Gives rise to this forms Zn hydroxide and release which gas hydrogen, but copper not release. Why? Because copper standard reduction potential, the elements which standard reduction potential is lesser than water, those only release hydrogen. Which standard reduction potential is more than water, those does not release hydrogen. Here lanthanides standard reduction potential is lesser than water. So here it is, means this contains negative reduction potentials, that's why they release hydrogen. So now here it is, after this here it is any other element, halogen you take X. For suppose this is LN plus 3 plus X minus gives rise to LnX3. So this LnX3 type halogens will form. And listen, all these compounds are which nature? Ionic in nature. Ionic in nature. So these are the chemical reactions. And next one, color. Colors. Like D block elements, these elements also show color, but complementary colors we won't explain. The which F block element show color, which F block element does not show color, that we can explain. Here there D to D transition, here F to F transition. That meaning F0 comma F14 colorless. Colorless, remaining colorful, remaining are colorful. That meaning F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, F6, F7, F8, F9, F10, F11, F12, F13 all are colorful, but F0, F14 are colorless. So here it is, the reason for color is F2F transaction. The complementary colors we won't give, just color or colorless. And one more question they will ask, in the following which elements have similar color. And listen in this, 4f to the power n and 4f to the power 14 minus n. These two colors are same. 4f to the power n, 4f to the power 14 minus n is same. For suppose, listen here, it is 14 minus n means this n equal to, I am taking 2. N equal to 2 I am taking. N equal to 2 means 4f2 and 4f12. These two colors are same. N equal to, I am taking 3. N equal to 3 means this is 4f3 and 4f11. These two are same. So means 4f2 configuration, 4f12 configuration colors are same. 4f3 configuration, 4f11 configuration colors are same. So like this, which are similar in color we can explain. Which are color, which are colorless, that also we can explain. This is the information about what colors of F block elements. This is not only for lanthanides, actinides also same. This is totally information about lanthanides. Next we will discuss actinides in the next class. Thank you.